This is the coffee station.
That is where we have been fueling up at all morning. Getting ready for this hike. Are you ready?
I am so ready.
Hey there folks, Luke and Susan here with the Outdoor Gear Review. Thank you very much for tuning in for this day hike adventure. Now this is a continuation of our road trip adventure to the Peaks of Otter area on the Blue Ridge Parkway.
We are currently on the Sharp Top Trail. We're heading to the top, a very strenuous 1.5 mile hike.
Right. It must be really strenuous. Everything that we see about this trail says like you better be in good shape.
Yeah.
To do it.
Yeah. So we don't know what to expect, but we're prepared. Like I said, we're currently on the trail. We just got started. A few people here and there, not terribly busy.
Right. Supposedly, the top up here is absolutely amazing. Cannot wait to go. Now, before we get to the very top, we are going to take a spur trail to Buzzard Rock. And then, from there, we are going to look for a crashed World War II bomber.
Yes.
It's a B-25D bomber plane that crashed on top of this mountain. We will talk more about that later on. Cross our fingers that we can actually find it.
I know. Cross your fingers that we find it.
Yeah. It's kind of a secret somewhat.
It is a secret.
Yeah. And everyone's real hush-hush about it, but I was able to find some GPS coordinates to it, so we will have to go off-trail. We will have to go bushwhacking to find it. We're prepared for that.
Yeah, you may or may not recall, but Luke and I have also found another plane crash site on top of Grandfather.
Right.
It was an adventure that we did. Pretty much people know about that one, though, and it's pretty easy to get to once you get to the top.
Right.
But it's kind of our thing. We like to do it. So when we found there's one here, we have to find it.
Yeah, we have to go find the plane crashes.
Yes.
So, folks, thank you for staying with us. Let's get going. Okay, so for this trip here, they estimate, what, 2 hours up?
Yeah, and an hour down.
2 hours for 1.5 miles.
That means it is going straight up. That's what it means.
So far, I have to say I like this trail.
It's a great trail.
It's really pretty. Very well taken care of. No garbage.
It looks well used.
Yeah. This trail is huge. Look at how wide this thing is.
It is wide. Maybe more people get out here than you realize.
Yeah, no doubt. So to talk about the weather real quick, how would you describe it?
Perfect weather.
Perfect.
60s.
Low 60 right now?
Yeah. Crisp,
yep.
Not hot,
no,
not too cool.
Perfect.
I think we'll be shedding our long sleeve layers soon.
This is about to come off.
But just perfect, perfect conditions.
He's exploring, he's hungry.
Very lucky that it's not raining today. Yesterday when we got here, it pretty much rained off and on all day long.
It did.
I was afraid that it was going to be pouring today.
We got lucky, but we put on our rain gear and walked around the lake last night.
Yep.
Which was nice.
This place is beautiful. If you guys haven't checked it out before, make sure to come to Peaks of Otter on the Blue Ridge Parkway in Virginia. Definitely uphill. This is a little bit strenuous.
Yeah.
What do you think, hon?
It is.
coming up here on a very rocky section. Getting hot?
Yeah, shedding the layers.
Oh yeah. I like this trail a lot already.
Too. The cool thing about this area is that the Indians were drawn to it, and you
right.
can see why.
Oh yeah.
You know, so it's an amazing,
it really
amazing
is.
Little area.
Ooh. This trail is awesome. I tell you, I am so thankful for that breeze coming in.
It feels great.
Oh my gosh, it feels awesome. I don't know about you, but I'm definitely sweating.
I haven't started sweating yet.
Yeah.
But I was hot. The breeze cools me down.
Yep. Now folks, you may be wondering about my knee. Has it recovered? Has it healed up? The answer is sort of. Kinda. It's not as painful as it once was, but I definitely still feel it. Namely, when I'm going downhill.
So this trail will be hurting you later.
Probably will. This is incredible.
Yeah,
steps going up. Check out these rocks. Hoo-hoo. Hi, Susie.
Hi. You made it.
Yep, lead the way, beautiful lady. You could tell already that the view from the top is going to be amazing.
Oh yeah.
Oh man, cannot wait. Now, a lot of you guys wonder, why don't I use trekking poles? And the reason is because of this right here, this camera.
The camera.
It makes it impossible.
Impossible.
Yeah. It's too much work to switch back and forth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They absolutely do help take the stress off of your knees.
Right.
So if you like them,
use them.
Use them. But it's just very difficult
breezy.
For us to do that.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the thing. I always have the camera on. I always have it ready to go so that I could catch the bear coming down out of the tree or
yeah.
whatever may happen. Yeah, they do make trekking poles where you can mount the camera to the top, and I've just found that to be really ineffective. It's too loose, too wobbly. I don't know, it's not my thing. When you put that weight on top, it really messes with the flow of it
right.
and how it works.
Right,
yeah.
So.
That's why, don't
That's
use trekking
why.
Poles. How awesome is it that people, volunteers, took time to make all of this?
I know, it's incredible.
How you doing?
Good.
Yeah. Now at this elevation, nothing has leafed out yet, but you go down a couple hundred feet and it's the leaf line.
Yeah, which is really cool.
Yeah, it's a straight line.
Of green.
Yeah, across the bottom of this mountain.
Yeah.
Now I don't know how you guys are physically when it comes to like hiking and running and so on. When I start off, I'm huffing and puffing from the get-go. Then I kind of break through what I call as the wall. Now, I could run this thing.
Yeah.
I'm raring to go. My motor's running. I'm ready to fly up this mountain.
I'm out of breath. I'm more like steady pace.
Right.
I don't want to run it. I don't want to go really slow. I'm just more like, I can keep going and going like the Energizer Bunny, but at one pace.
Right. I'm like a train. I start off slow, then I get going real fast. And maybe that's why I'm constantly like hurting myself, injuring myself and so on.
I would say for sure.
Yeah.
You know, you can't run up this. That's why your knee hurts.
Yeah. Oh, geez.
It's funny.
We're definitely going up in elevation here. The views are spectacular. We will show these to you guys later on when we get to the top. Save the best for last. You know what I mean?
Wow.
Yeah. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. You guys are in for a treat when we get to the top. I cannot show you this view until
Not
we
yet.
Get to the top because it's too good. You guys need to see the entire thing. Wow.
What do you think about that?
Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
Virginia is a beautiful state.
Gosh, it is.
I mean, I've always thought North Carolina is awesome, but wow.
Yeah.
We are definitely drawn to Virginia. This is really, really beautiful. Actually, our entire time in Virginia has been incredible as far as beauty goes.
They say that Virginia's for lovers too.
Yeah, Virginia's for lovers, so ladies, I know you want to come here with your significant other.
Right.
Because you ought to be here at Peaks of Otter.
Oh, you're clever.
Now, if I was an owl...
I was going to say, an owl lives there.
Yeah. I would live inside of this. That is cool.
Now, with the bomber that crashed up here, we will give you guys more information about that later on when we find it. If we find it. Supposedly there is a trail in the woods. You just have to know exactly what it is before you head out on it. I do have some GPS coordinates, which hopefully will take us straight to the crash site. From what I understand, it's like very steep down the slope of this mountain.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can fall very easily.
Right.
Have to be careful.
Yep.
Fearless. Wow. Hey, buddy.
We had heard that the animal life up here is super friendly. They're not very scared at all. And that's obviously true.
I'd seen other videos of people, like the deer would just come right up to them.
Right.
I don't know if they were petting it or feeding it.
Huh.
You're really not supposed to feed.
Yeah.
The animals, because you don't know what you might give them that would hurt them.
Yep, you'd be surprised. Even everyday, just simple, casual things can hurt animals. I mean, like, for example, grapes are toxic to many animals.
Yep, raisins.
Raisins, stuff like that.
Take a look at these boulders. It's just like big balls that are just, you know.
Big round rocks.
Yeah, they're just rolling down the mountain.
As far as intensity goes, you know, it's definitely uphill. It's strenuous, but it's not terrible by any means. We've definitely done rougher and more intense on the channel. For example, Callaway Peak, Grandfather Mountain, much steeper than this. This goes around the mountain, Callaway Peak, straight up.
Wow. This place is just one gigantic boulder field.
It is. Look at those.
Yeah. Trail maintenance. Yeah. How are you?
Hello.
Thank you for your hard work.
Oh, thank you.
It is appreciated. Whew. How are you? Thank you for your hard work.
Thank you, sir. Y'all have a wonderful day.
Hey, thank you.
That right there is why we have such nice trails to walk on. Most of these people are volunteers. I think when we get older, we should volunteer our time.
That is what I want to do.
Yeah. Looks like we might have the buzzard's roost over this way. Excellent.
So we are heading this direction to the buzzard's roost first, then we'll come back and do Sharp Top.
Okay, folks. Buzzard's roost is about 600 feet in this direction behind me.
Right.
Luke and I noticed a little trail over here. You can see it's kind of got some debris in front of it, but we're kind of thinking that might be the way that we want to go. So let's head off that direction.
Okay.
So we're going to follow this trail for a little bit here. On my phone, I have an app. It is called TNP. And so I entered the coordinates on it, set a waypoint for supposedly the crash site.
Keep your eyes peeled for any kind of plane wreckage. Everything I've read about this is that it was just strewn all over this mountain.
Right.
And of course over time it's washed down the mountain, so it is right on the face of this mountain.
Yep.
What are you finding out?
Okay, I believe that we are on the right track. We're going to continue to head down on the slope of this mountain.
Okay.
It looks like it's going to be just straight down here.
Okay.
Yep, let's see. Looks like we need to go down about roughly 100 feet to find it.
Okay.
Yep, so once we find the plane, we'll head back up here to Buzzard's Roost, then head on over to Sharp Top.
Cool.
Definitely be careful.
Okay.
Yeah, this is steep. Very, very steep. Exploring, folks. I love it.
I was just thinking, what goes down must come back up. So we're going to be climbing.
Yeah.
This.
Hopefully the GPS coordinates, which I found online, are accurate. That's the kicker right there, isn't it?
Yeah,
if they're accurate. I will make sure to tell you all if they are. So if you're watching this video and you want to check this place out yourself, you guys can find it real easy. Now, one thing that we're looking for as we hike down here is debris. We're looking for anything that doesn't look natural. We're looking for anything that's reflective. So we're keeping our eyes open, kind of spanning around, because supposedly, like Susan said before, the destruction, the debris is just everywhere. And like this plane exploded upon impact. I guess it was very intense. 5 individuals died. I think I've found the wreckage down below here. Go down on your butt if you have to.
Yeah.
So folks, we are thinking down here. Oh yeah, I think that's wreckage.
It is.
Yeah, I think so. For the most part, there has been a trail which is going down to this plane crash. Based on what we were reading on the internet, it sounded like there was a lot of people who did not want this information getting out about the location of this crash. When you try to keep stuff like this hidden, that encourages people to do more damage than what they would do naturally. Also, it causes more destruction and damage to the environment.
You found it?
Yeah, here's part of the engine, folks. Wow.
Oh my. Look how far down it goes.
Oh yeah, wow. Okay. So here's part of the engine, I believe. That is incredible, huh?
World War II bomber, right?
Yep. World War II B-25D bomber.
Wow. Look how it's like melted.
Yeah. Isn't that incredible, folks? This thing is actually melted. Not just rusted in spots, from where the heat was so intense.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna touch it.
Yeah. This is a piece of history right here, yeah. Over 70 years old.
Look at that.
Yeah. Imagine the impact that it would take to bend something like that.
Mm-hmm.
On February 2nd, 1943, a B-25D United States Air Force bomber crash-landed on the side of Buzzard's Roost near Sharp Top Mountain in the Peaks of Otter Recreation Area in southwest Virginia. The 5 crew members were killed instantly in a fiery explosion. From nose to tail, the plane measured 53 feet. It stood 16 feet 4 inches tall, 35,000 pounds. It could hit 272 miles an hour. This is pretty intense just being here, isn't it?
It is. It just makes you feel, I don't know.
Yeah.
Check this out.
Some parts of the plane here. I'm not sure what that is. Out of respect for those who died, out of respect for their families, we're not going to take anything. This is a part of history. The night that it crashed on February 2nd, it was roughly 9 p.m., this plane was actually seen cruising through the night sky. It was out of South Carolina doing a low-level training flight. And supposedly, they could hear the sound of the engine. Something wasn't right, spitting and sputtering. Low altitude, the blinkers were on, and crash right into the side of this mountain. Roughly 3,100 feet. That is crazy, huh?
Uh-huh. It's hard to explain, like, the experience that you kind of get when you know, like, look where we are, look what happened.
Gosh, there's just pieces of this plane everywhere, huh? Mm-hmm. Like, there's just little chunks of metal just
everywhere,
scattered everywhere. It's incredible. Mm-hmm. That is wild, folks. This is very steep.
It is.
You do have to be careful. Gosh, it goes all the way down this mountain, doesn't it?
Yeah, look.
I mean, look, it just keeps going.
There's a big piece down there.
Yeah. And you have parts, pieces scattered just everywhere. It goes all the way down the mountain. There's another chunk of the wing down there. Here's the plaque that they put up. It was from the Columbia Army Air Base in South Carolina. Gosh, 1943.
Mm-hmm.
That is a long time ago, folks. From what I've read, it is a mystery as to what happened here with this plane exactly. You know, nobody really knows what happened. The Army could not come up here, or the Air Force could not make their way up here to get all the wreckage. It's too remote, too steep.
And they didn't have time.
Yeah.
I mean, look what was going on in the world at that time. They
right.
did not have time to do it. So here it lies still to this day.
That's it. What'd you find, Susie?
I'm not sure.
Oh. Go ahead and grab it. It's a geocache, I think.
Is?
I think so.
Hey, we found something.
Hey, Susie found a geocache.
I did?
Yeah, let's see what's in here.
Cool.
Now, with a cache like this, you're supposed to take something and you're also supposed to leave something.
This is the Sharp Top B-25 crash site cache. 8/17/14.
Wow.
August 17th, 2014. And we just found it?
Yeah. Okay, you gotta sign the list. Sign the book, I think.
Please sign and return cache as you found it. Oh.
You should write a secret message to the Outdoor Gear Review viewers. That way, when they make their way out here, they can find it and read it. Okay, so folks, Susan is writing the secret message here. You guys have to come. You have to find the cache. It's right next to this rock, right? We didn't have any coordinates to this thing, so as long as no one moves it, it should be right here behind the rock, behind the plaque. So you have to come out here, you have to do this hike, and check this out, right?
That is a great note to leave.
All right, so viewers, get out here, read this book.
Right. If you find this, there's instructions for you. Something special will happen.
All said and done.
Okay, we've added something. We've written in the book. We're going to put this back for the next person.
Cool. Now, folks, remember, it is behind the rock with the plaque. Okay, let's keep going down. Let's check out some more wreckage here. Try not to slide down this mountain. Yeah. That might be part of it. Whoa. Woo.
Are you okay?
Yes. About ate it. Whew. About fell into this thing. It's steep. Instead of going all the way down to the base of this mountain, we've decided that it's time to head back up.
Oh yeah, we've never got to the top yet to see the views.
Yeah.
So.
Hey, we have a strenuous crawl back up to the top here.
We gotta climb up there.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, there's so much debris. I mean, it just keeps on going. It's all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, we've paid our respects. Very easy to find, folks. You'll read online that it's very difficult. That's not the case at all.
No.
There's a trail. As you guys saw up there, it's in between the Buzzard's Roost and Sharp Top.
Mm-hmm.
Just take it, go down. It's very, very steep. Simple. Be careful.
Be careful, and remember, leave no trace.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yep. And don't take anything. Don't scratch your name on everything.
Don't take anything.
Yep. I know that our viewers wouldn't do stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. All right. You want to crawl back up?
Let's crawl back up.
All right.
Susan and I were talking about, we assume that it's the locals in this area who have really tried to keep this hush-hush. But the truth is, folks, that only makes it worse.
Yeah, we all like a good treasure.
Yeah, everybody wants to go treasure hunting. So if you turn it into a game, that's what happens, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you turn it into a game, people come out here and they take home paces. They're doing exactly what you don't want them to do.
Yep.
You cannot stop people from coming out here. You can't do it.
Mm-mm.
Like I said, common sense goes a long way.
Yeah.
Yeah. Woo! Did it, babe. Found the plane. I wasn't sure if we were going to be able to.
I know. It's awesome.
Yeah. From everything that we read online, so I'm like, the chances were high that we weren't going to find it. But that was easy.
It was.
Yeah.
The trail's right there, guys.
Yeah, it really is.
When you come up the mountain here, you're at the fork of the road. You can go to Sharp Top this direction. That's the direction up to the roost. Right here is the trail down to the plane. Extremely steep. Be careful.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
Let's go to the roost.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Wow, this rock is awesome. How did that thing get on top of that one?
Check this out, folks. Good Lord.
Do you like that, Susie?
I do, but...
Wow. You want to come up?
I'm good right here.
Okay.
I was like, maybe just feeling unsteady after all the climbing.
Sure. There's not a whole lot of area for you to really get comfortable at.
Yeah.
Where you get your good footing.
I know.
I was definitely feeling uneasy up there on the top, but had to do it.
So we're inside of this shelter here. Wow.
Wow, so cool.
This is wild.
We were talking to some of the people hiking here, and everybody's real cool. I tell you what, everybody that we've met so far has been super nice. We've met people from Florida, from Roanoke, all over the place. We were talking to one guy, him and his daughter. He was part of like the Civil Air Patrol, if I could say that right. And basically did some like rescue operations. So he'd been to like a number of plane crashes. And one of them, it was two guys smuggling like pot and something else. They had crashed. And they said that when they made it up to the crash site, there's just cash and like cannabis everywhere. How crazy is that?
Such a wild story.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, I love hiking. I love backpacking. And the people that you meet are just as interesting as the sites that you will see.
Sharp Top Mountain, elevation 3,875 feet.
That is absolutely stunning. Wow.
So there's the lodge down there. Wow.
Woo!
Okay, so Susie, what do you think about this hike?
Absolutely spectacular.
Yeah. I think this is a must. You have to come out here and check this
out.
It's
amazing.
It is.
It's amazing. Well, let's grab some...
Coffee?
Coffee. Let's grab a snack for some fuel.
Folks, we hate to interrupt this video, but we want to take 1 second, not literally, about 20 seconds, to say that we do have a Patreon page ready to go. If you check out the description box, you will find a link to it.
Yes, you guys asked for it, so we made one. We appreciate any support from you guys, no matter how big or small.
Right.
It is greatly appreciated.
That's right. The Outdoor Gear Review is the home of the agenda-free review. We never pass on a review in an attempt to sell you a product. We have no store, no Amazon store, nothing like that. So our profits come from Google AdSense, which you see in the ads at the beginning of the video, and from you all.
Yes.
That's right. You guys help us out. So that's it. If you guys want to pledge a donation to the channel, it is appreciated. If you can't, we understand.
Yes.
So thanks, guys. Back to the video.
Thank you. All right, folks. We are going to finish up our coffee and chill here on top of the mountain for a little bit, and then we're going to head back down.
Yep.
You guys have seen all the views. It's just fantastic here, so we're just going to soak it up. Thanks for tuning in on this little day hike adventure.
Yeah, it has been so much fun. We hope you guys have enjoyed the road trip as well. Until next time, everybody, take care, strength and honor, be well.
Bye.